a miracle today. Come and do a miracle today. Destiny changer.
Turn with me to the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter number 8. We will read verse 20, 21, and 22. Jeremiah 8, 20, 21, and 22, the Bible says, "The harvest is past, the summer has ended. We are not saved. Since my people are crushed, I am crushed. I mourn, and horror grips me. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is there no healing for the wound of my people?" Father, we want to thank you so much for your word. Your word is life, and we cannot live without your word. We pray this morning that you may help us not only to hear the word, but also to apply it in our lives. And I pray, dear Lord, for those that will take this word that is shared this morning to heart, Father, that it will take them to another level of their walk with you, of their spiritual well-being. And I pray that it will help to them spiritually. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Now, one of the exciting moments for me every year is the time that God allows us to come together and unveil the theme for the year. I am excited every moment, every year, that when we come together, we unveil the theme and we celebrate what we believe that God is saying to us as a church family. And this year, we were here again as we ushered in the year, and God had given us a theme that 2016 will be a year of divine favor for fruitfulness and increase. And of course, we also then have the time of prayer and fasting, where we ask us to write our expectations for the year. And I know there are many of us who faithfully do that. We write our expectations down, and during the time of prayer and fasting, we come together and we continue to pray over those needs, over those expectations. And then we trust the Lord that as the year unfolds, the Lord will answer or will usher us through into those expectations. And some of them have been for jobs. Others have been for promotion. Others have been for spouses. Others have been for businesses to rise. Others have been for, you know, God's intervention in our lives. Others have been for loved ones to get born again. Others have been for babies to be, you know, for us to be babies. Others have been that our marriages be transformed. Others have been that God opens up international doors for us. We have all kinds of expectations that we bring before every year, and we believe God to see us through them or to usher us into them every year. And as the year unfolds and we get to November and we get to December, and the answers have not come, many times, you know, we begin to either get excuses, either maybe, you know, God has a better thing, or you can come up with excuses and say, this was not the will of God. You can come up with excuses and say, you know, God's timing is not my timing. We now begin to realize that time is coming, the year is ending, and what I trusted the Lord for may not come to pass. And many of those reasons that we place there may be correct, but I want us to speak this morning on delays. Delays. Why does God allow delays into our lives? the answers and the solutions that we are trusting Him for take forever or come at the time that we experience them. Now, the Bible contains many examples of people who waited for very long periods of time for God's help or for God's intervention or for God's miracles. And the Jews who are in Egypt for 430 years, you know, in slavery. That was not their land, but they stayed there for 430 years. And part of that 430 years was not a very exciting moment because the new Pharaoh came in and they were made slaves proper. They were pushed and they were harassed and they were given hard labor, you know, and they sought the Lord and they cried to the Lord and God eventually intervened. They did not ask the Lord today and tomorrow. There was the intervention. It took a long time. Then they began the journey to the promised land that God had promised them. And there was another additional 40 years for them to arrive to the promised land. Many of them died in the wilderness waiting for the promised land, for them to get to Canaan. But, you know, it took that long. Abraham waited for a son that God had promised him. Remember, for Abraham, he did not even write down his expectation. He never went to the Lord and said, I want a son. God himself came and spoke to Abraham and said, you know, you are going to be a father of many nations. And what an exciting moment. I never prayed for it. And God just spoke to me. He's going to bless me. He's going to lift me up and make me somebody in the society or in this nation. I never prayed for it. I want to believe that I will be so excited for such a miracle or for such a promise if God was to give me that kind of a promise. But then Abraham waited for 25 years for the son that God had promised. And when God opened up the womb of his wife Sarah, you know, it was only one son that Sarah gave birth to. And, you know, when you are talking about a father of many nations, I'm thinking of son number one and son number two and son number three. And the quiver is full, whether it's 7 or 14 or whatever number it is. But it was one Isaac that was born for, you know, after waiting for 25 years. And then a man of God by the name Simeon prayed to God and says, I don't want to die until I see the Messiah. And God gives him a number of years to be alive. And he's getting older and older and older. And then one time, you know, Mary and Joseph brings Jesus to the temple, you know, to be dedicated. And he says, now your servant has seen the Messiah. The day I was waiting for, I'm now ready to die. It took a long time for that promise to be fulfilled. And of course, you can mention many others. You can talk of Anna praying and trusting the Lord. Year after year, they went to Shiloh and there was no son coming. You can talk of Job crying to the Lord as he went through all the things that he had to go through, the pain and the, you know, the anguish and the decay of his body, and things were not happening. You are here this morning and you had expectations. You have prayed, you have fasted, you have given a seed, you have actually, you know, done all that you know you could do, and your promise has not come. Your prayer is not answered. The solutions has not come. The way has not been opened. The doors are still closed. What are you going to do about this? This morning, I want to talk to you about delays, and I want to give you several reasons as to why delays happen. It is not always to be spiritualized. There are times that we need to be practical and ask ourselves, what is it that we have done to delay this prayer ourselves? Because there are times God already released it, and there are times also God is waiting for you to do something in order for him to release the blessing. So there are reasons, several reasons, why our answers, our solutions can be delayed. They may not be all, you know, all the reasons that are there. There may be more, but I want to share with us about 10 reasons why delay may happen in your life. Reason number one. There are delays that are caused by disobedience. Yes, you placed your expectations before the Lord. Yes, you fasted and prayed. Yes, you trusted God, you know, to do what it is that you're praying for. But there could be disobedience in your life that is causing the delay for the answer to your prayers. In Psalm 81, verse number 10 to 14, the Bible says, I am the Lord your God who brought you up out of Egypt. Open wide your mouth and I will fill it. He's talking to the children of Israel. But my people will not listen to me. Israel would not submit to me. So I gave them over to their stubborn hearts to follow their own devices. If my people would only listen to me, if Israel would only follow my ways. Verse 14. How quickly I will subdue their enemies and turn my hand against their foes. How quickly I will subdue their enemies and turn my hand against their foes. But it was not happening as quickly as God would have desired for it to happen. And maybe, you know, they were there and crying to God to deliver them from, you know, their enemies. And they are wondering, why is God not answering this prayer? Why is God not defending us? Why is God not fighting for us? And God is saying, you are disobedient. You do not do what I instruct you to do. If only you will listen, if only you will do what I instruct you to do, you will be surprised how quickly I will do it. And this morning you may be here and the year is coming to an end and you have expectations that you have been trusting God for, and maybe you're wondering what is happening. I am here to tell you, if you're walking in disobedience, you will spiritualize that need or that answer the way you may want to. You may even go for prayers, anointing to be anointed. You may plant the seed, but as long as you continue in disobedience, God will not come through for you. And it is not because he doesn't want to. It is not because he doesn't like you. It is not because he doesn't, you know, he does not have the resources to do it. He has all the ability. He has all the power. He has all the resources to do it. He had your prayer. He knows what you need. But you are walking in disobedience. There are things God has instructed you to do. There are ways God wants you to walk. There are things God wants you to be involved in and not be involved in. So long as you walk in disobedience, your answer is delayed. Your solution is delayed. And I know you. Disobedience. Hallelujah. So long as you are walking in disobedience, God is waiting for you to change your ways. God is waiting for you to listen. And the word is saying, you will be surprised how quickly that door will open. You will be surprised how quickly that promotion will come. You will be surprised how quickly your eyes will open to see the spouse you have been looking for. You will be surprised how quickly God will show you a way out of the situation. But the problem is, God is saying, my children do not listen to me. My children are walking in disobedience. If only they could listen to me, they will see how quickly I will, you know, deliver them from their enemies. And you can change, deliver them from their enemies to whatever it is that you're trusting God. It could be, you will be surprised how quickly I will supply, how quickly I will fight for you, how quickly I will, you know, take you through whatever it is, how quickly I will give you the promotion, how quickly I will bring your wedding to happen. Praise the name of the Lord. God is saying, if only we could listen to him. And if you're here this morning and December 31st is approaching and you're wondering, God, when will my answer come? When will my solution come? And you are fasting and you're praying, and at the same time you're walking in disobedience. At the same time you're not listening to the voice of God. At the same time you're not listening to the instructions of God. I don't care how many days you're going to fast, and I don't care how many seeds you plant. So long as you are walking in disobedience, you are delaying your own solution. You are delaying your own answer. You are delaying your own miracle. God wants to bless you, but you need to do an inward check, an inward audit. Hallelujah. And ask yourself, what is it that is causing the delay? It is not enough to just get to prayer without interrogating ourselves and asking ourselves, what would be the cause of this delay? And especially if I know that I'm walking in disobedience, it is not just about me crying the more and going before the Lord the more. I need to ask myself, and if God reveals to me that I'm walking in disobedience, then I need to make things right with Him so that the delay can be taken care of and God can usher me into my miracle and into my blessing. Praise the name of the Lord. If you are here this morning and you needed a miracle this year, you needed God to intervene in your life this year, you needed God to open doors in your life this year, you needed intervention in an area of your life, and you know for sure that there are ways that you are walking in disobedience, my suggestion to you is stop the prayers now. Ask the Lord for forgiveness. Ask Him to help you to begin to live in obedience. And you will see how quickly before 31st God will do the thing that He has promised to do for you. It is not enough for me to just come here and declare things to you. You know, this week will not end before this and this happens to you. We love those kind of things. Within 7 days, you will be blessed. And we get excited. And we know very well we are not living right with God. And we are expecting God to just because somebody made some declaration that things will happen. They will not. Better check your life and do what you need to do so that you can deal with this delay and God will bless you. I am here to tell you, I believe in a God who knows that a day can be like 1,000 years and 1,000 years can be, like 1 day. I believe in a God who can bless you in a matter of hours. I believe in a God who can turn situations upside down and downside up in a moment. But I also believe in a God who honors His word, a God who, has placed principles that need to be followed, and a God who cannot just be taken for granted. Praise the name of the Lord. This is the God we serve. He wants to bless you, but you need to turn away from your disobedience. Reason number two, why delay can happen in our lives is as a result of doubt. When you live a life of doubt, today you are trusting God, tomorrow you are questioning whether God is able. You may not say it audibly, but in your heart you are wondering, will God ever do this? Can God do this? Has anybody in my position ever, amounted to this? Has anybody from my region ever succeeded, ever made it? You are doubting God, and yet you are also praying and trusting God to do things for you. The second reason why you may experience delay to your answers, to your solutions, to your prayer requests can be as a result of doubt. James chapter 1, verse number 5-8, the Bible says, "If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. Here you are praying and trusting God for a miracle to make a way for you. But here is a principle of how you can receive from God miracles and answers and solutions. God is saying, so long as you doubt me, so long as you live a life of doubt, double-minded, you know, one side or one portion of you believes that God is able, God is almighty, God is a miracle worker, but there is also the other side of you that always believes, I don't know whether this will happen. It has never happened to anybody of my size or in my gender or from my tribe, and you are asking and wondering whether it will happen. You are living in doubt, and God will not answer that prayer as a result of that doubt, because it is you who now is delaying, you know, the answer or the solution or the miracle to whatever it is that you're asking God. I've come to tell you today, you need to believe God without doubting him, because God is not a man that he will promise you something and then, you know, he lets you down. God is not a man that will promise you something and then he realizes he does not have what it takes to fulfill the promise. God is God. Hallelujah. He has all the power. He has all the resources. He has all the wisdom, and he can do anything for you. And therefore, when you believe God and trust God, you need to take him at his word. When God gives you a word, like a theme that we have for the year, take God at his word. Believe him without doubting in any way, because God is all powerful. These are reasons why you should not doubt God. And one, he is all powerful. Two, he created all things. Three, he has control over all things. Four, he loves you with an infinite love. Number five, he has given awesome promises to you that he is going to keep and to fulfill. You have no reason why you should doubt God in your life. God is not Bishop T. He's not a man that he may give you some word and then tomorrow he does not fulfill it. And therefore, if you are here this morning and there are things you have been trusting God for this year and you are wondering, we are in November, will it ever happen? Will it ever come to pass? Check your life right now and ask yourself, have you totally believed God? Do you totally trust that he is able? Do you totally trust in his power? Do you totally believe that God loves you and that God is able to see you through whatever it is that he has promised you? Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let me tell you that God does not love you because of the things you do. He loves you just as you are. Hallelujah. He loves you before you have done anything. He still loves you. That is how gracious he is. And so when you come into times of your life and you begin to wonder, oh, maybe it's because I did that. Maybe it's because, you know, maybe God does not love me more because this and this has happened. No, no, no. God still loves you. He's not a man who loves you today and tomorrow he doesn't love you anymore. You know, men lifts up people and they bring them down, but God lifts you up and wants you to stay there so long as you will walk with him, so long as you will obey him, so long as you will believe in him. So don't doubt God at any time when he has promised things. Maybe your delay is as a result of the fact that you are living in doubt. You have not placed your faith fully to God. You are questioning certain things, and that is why your answer is delaying. I have come to tell you that things can change this morning. If you will decide and say, I will believe God. It does not matter how things look on the outside, and it does not matter what I have, and it does not matter, you know, what people are saying around me. I want to believe God that he is able and that whatever he has promised, he will deliver. Then God will do what he has said in Psalm 81. Quickly he will come and show you the way and provide for you and usher you into your miracle. But maybe you are here and you are praying and you are, you know, fasting and you are doing other things. The only thing you are not checking is your faith, and whether you are living in doubt and whether you are living in fear, And whether you are living in anxiety, and whether you are living in worry, that is the only thing you don't check. All the other things you're doing, you're fasting, you're praying, you are making declarations. But at the same time, you are anxious, you are worried, you are fearful, you have doubt. Things are going to delay until the moment that you begin to trust the Lord fully, that He is well able to see you through. Praise the name of the Lord. Reason number three why delay may happen in your life is attempt to manipulate God. An attempt to manipulate God, it will never work. Things will be delayed until you know that God is God. He cannot be manipulated. You know how people manipulate God? The example that has been given that has been good is when children want something. When children want you to buy them something and you know very well they should not get that, children can manipulate parents, and they can go to, you can go with a child to supermarket and you had already decided that something is happening to the teeth of your child and therefore they are not supposed to take sweets anymore. But you go to the supermarket and children are children. I don't know where they get this wisdom from, thinking, oh, now that there are so many people in the supermarket, here we go, mom. I am going to make you buy that sweet whether you like it or not. So you get into the supermarket and the child begins, mommy, I want a sweet. And it's like, no. You know that you are not supposed to take, mommy, I want a sweet. You are not supposed to take sweet. No, mommy, I want a sweet. And look at everybody's now looking at you. And mommy, I want a sweet. Mommy, I want a sweet. So, you know, the more you say no, the more they are talking, the more they are crying, the more they are stamping their feet, and the more they are grabbing. And of course, people who don't even know you, people who don't even know the reason why you are not buying the sweet, warakuja, mommy, si umnunulie tu sweet. Just give her the sweet so that she can keep quiet. You know, people trying to help the child manipulate you. And it will depend now if you are manipulable. Then you will say, okay, take. And you give them even three so that they can keep quiet. You go out and the child knows, next time I want something, that is what I do. God will not be manipulated. You can put your tantrums, it will never work. You say, I'm not going to serve in the choir anymore. I have been waiting and trusting, and God is not doing something. I will stop serving. I will stop going to church. I have come to tell you, somebody, manipulation will delay your miracle, will delay your answers and solutions. It's time that you stopped and looked inward and said, what am I doing? Do I believe that God is God? And He can do what no man can do. His time is the best for me. When God says, this is not good for you, then I need to accept it and allow God to be God. Don't try to manipulate God. Don't go ahead of God and do things, you know, in your own ways and then accept God to bless it. That is another way that we manipulate God, you know. God is late, so let me just go and get married. Then, you know, God will bless that. It's like you are trying to help God. Nobody is coming. Nobody is approaching. So what is the best way? The quickest is get pregnant and then go and tell your friend, by the way, I am. Now what do we do? Oh, you know. My parents will not accept this. Okay, basi come. That is where come we stay comes from. That's it, come we stay. So you go. And then, of course, you disappear for 6 months or 1 year out of Praise Chapel. You don't come. And then you come back, you know, with your baby and your child. And you know what you expect? You expect me to tell you, you got a baby out of, you're living in sin. Get out of here. And you don't see me say that. And you're saying, yes. They have accepted. So you continue living your life and you are expecting God to bless you and to do things in your life. I have come to tell you something. It's not that I don't know that you need to make things right with God. It's not that I don't know that there are things that are not working right in your life. But my prayer is that you will come to the place where you will also deal with God in this situation. Don't expect me to expel you out of this place. This is a place for people to hear God, get reconciled, get delivered and get help to go back to the right path and live and serve God. It's not a club where we say, you got pregnant, get out of here. You stole, get out of here. You whatever, get out. No, 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 no. That is not going to happen. But we are going to trust God that you will come to your senses and you will go before the Lord, because there are so many other things that you will miss out even if you went your way around and got whatever you think you got. In 1 Samuel chapter 13, verse number 9 to 14, you know, Saul is waiting for Samuel, the prophet of God, to come so that he can, do what he needs to do as a prophet so that they can win the war. Samuel is getting late, and so Saul decides that I am going to do the offering myself. I am going to go and offer the sacrifice myself. He is not the prophet. He is not the priest. He's the king. And so he goes and offers it himself. And you know what? Then God says, I have rejected you. I have rejected you. And I'm raising up a king for myself. And even that war, they lost it. I'm here to tell you, you cannot quicken your own process in your own ways, with your own methods, in your own design, and then expect God to continue blessing your life. It never happens. Some of the delays and maybe even denials will come when we try to manipulate God. Reason number 4, why delay may be caused is as a result of wrong motivation to that prayer. The Bible says in the book of James, chapter 4, verse number 3. James chapter 4. The Bible says, when you ask, you do not receive, because you ask with wrong motives, that you may spend what you get on your pleasures. You adulterous people, don't you know that friendship with the world means enmity against God? Therefore, anyone who chooses to be a friend of the world becomes an enemy of God. Verse number 3, when you ask, you do not receive, because you ask with wrong motives, that you may spend whatever you get on your pleasures. Hallelujah. Do you know that thieves can steal and pray that the police do not show up? You go and rob, and then, oh God, let the police not get all of us. Let them not see us. So you get out. You think God has answered that? When we get things for our own pleasure, you are praying for things for your own pleasure. The motive is wrong. God will not be party to that. And sometimes, when our motives are wrong, and we are asking God to do things with wrong motives, and they are delayed, we don't get them, it is for your own good. And some of us are crying and complaining and blaming God. He's not doing this. He's not doing whatever. Let me tell you, there are some very selfish prayers. If God was to answer today, your life will be totally ruined. Hallelujah. There are some selfish prayers today that if God was to answer, the lives of the people around you will never be the same. If you want promotion, you don't pray the boss out of work. Are we together? You go to the office early and you anoint the door and you say, I possess this office in Jesus' name. Come on. God is the one who raises and is the one who brings down. And who told you the only way to be promoted is for that boss to get out or die or whatever? There are some very selfish prayers we make that if if they were to be answered, people will be dying left, right, and center in your life because you want this way, so they might die. They must go away so that I can get this. I have come to tell you this morning, don't pray selfish prayers. Don't have selfish motives and expect that you are going to operate with God. You're going to team up with God so that he can do miracles in your life. When things are out there for wrong motives, then they will not happen. If you are having concubines and your salary is not enough, of course it will not be enough. So you are praying for increment. What for? God, 100% increment, promotion in the name of Jesus. I declare it. It shall come to pass. Which one? From which God? Because you realize you can't meet the needs of her and her and her and her. Why? Because they have become too many. And so God, I pray for promotion. I pray for increment. This is the year of fruitfulness and increase, Lord. Increase me. Increase my money. For what? For your selfish needs? It will never happen. Praise the name of the Lord. Number 5. Delay can be caused by lack of responsibility. Lack of responsibility. There are times when God does not meet a need because we have ignored or refused to shoulder our responsibility in particular matters. God expects you to be a responsible person, a responsible steward. And if you are not responsible, you cannot be praying for more increment, for more blessings, miracles to happen, and you are irresponsible. God blesses you with things, but you don't take care of them. You don't, you know, you don't nurture. You don't, you have given a shamba. It cannot produce anything because you don't go there to till it. You don't plant the seed. You are not careful what is being planted in that. You know, there's lack of responsibility on your part, and you are fasting and praying. God is going to say, get responsible and I will bless you. And you will be surprised how quickly I will bless your life. Praise the name of the Lord. There are people who are praying for jobs, but they are expecting the bosses, they are expecting jobs to look for them. You are waiting for the day somebody will come. By the way, there is a job at our place. You apply. You will never take the initiative. There's no responsibility on your part. Things don't work that way. Praise the name of the Lord. Proverbs chapter number 19. Proverbs 19 and verse number 15. The Bible says, laziness brings on deep sleep, and the shiftless go hungry. If you are lazy, you are not responsible. I don't care how much you speak in tongues. Laziness will ruin your life. Praise the name of the Lord. God is not going to bless laziness. You cannot be there. You don't want to work. You don't want to be responsible. You don't want to take any initiative. The only thing you can do is go on your knees. Oh, God. Oh, God. Come on. God wants you to get responsible. Praise the name of the Lord. So maybe some of the miracles have not taken place. Not because your grandfather did something. There are so many things we accuse our, you know, our ancestors for. Things are not happening because always we are pointed to the family. Oh, you know, your grandfather, there's a cycle going on. We need to get to the places where we can interrogate ourselves. Praise the name of the Lord. And if there are things we need to do, then we need to do them. Reason number six, that may cause delay. Delay may be caused by God's redirection or God redirecting your paths or your need into something else. Sometimes God can decide to redirect you in preparation for something new, something bigger, or something better than what you are asking for. Praise the name of the Lord. You need to look at the life of Joseph. You know, Joseph, when he was put into the pit, his need at that particular time was for God to deliver him out of the pit and go back home. He's delivered and he ends up in slavery. When he's in slavery, maybe he's praying God for protection and provision. Then God leads him to the house of Potiphar, and the provision is there. The protection is there. He, in fact, is even doing better. You know, things have become so good. And then all of a sudden, you know, maybe there he's saying, now that you have blessed me, Lord, now that I have favor with this man, now cause him to release me so that I can go back home. And instead of that, you know, that prayer, that need is redirected. He ends up in prison. Maybe in prison he's praying, oh God, now I don't deserve this. God, do something. And he stays there and he interprets the dreams and he said, now this is the way God is going to answer the prayer. And the person that is supposed to speak on his behalf when he goes back to the king's palace forgets him for 2 more years in prison. And Joseph's prayer, a need, is redirected. But when God now brings the answer, hallelujah, it's not an ordinary answer. He is now the prime minister of Egypt. And he did it so that he can not only, you know, help himself and be able to, you know, rise up to position, but he is now helping and, you know, rescuing the entire nation of Israel. So maybe some of your answers and solutions, miracles are delayed because God is redirecting your paths. What you need to do is interrogate you and say, I've checked. I'm not living in disobedience. I've checked. I am not selfish. I've checked. I'm not trying to manipulate God. So God, let your will be done. Praise the name of the Lord. In your own time. And God will do exactly that. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Have you ever prayed for something and instead of it happening, something totally different and maybe worse and maybe not even connected to the prayer happened to you, and then you begin to wonder, is this what I was asking God for? Is it all right? I was expecting God as a reason why those kind of things happen to us. Number seven, delays can be caused by God's desire to teach us. God can decide to train you patience through delayed answer to your prayer. You cry and you throw tantrums until you come to the point and say, God, I surrender. God, do it your own way, at your own time. I know you are God. I cannot, you know, fight with you. I cannot cry now for you. I surrender to you, Lord. Whichever way you want to do it, at whatever time you want to do it, you are God. You are almighty. You are all powerful. Do it your way at your own time. You have just learned patience in a way that can never be taught to you in a classroom. Hallelujah. So God can delay an answer to teach us an important lesson, like that one of patience. He can teach you on how to trust him and wait on him. He can show you that it is not the job that is taking care of you. It is not the business that is meeting your needs. I am the Lord, your God, who meets your needs. Because you are not getting any breakthrough, but you are not lacking. God is supplying. He's teaching you something. Reason number 8. Delay can be caused by rejection of God's method. If you reject the method of God, you want it your way, you want it your style, you want it served in the way that you want it served, then you are going to wait. God will wait for you to allow him to use his own ways, his own method. Praise the name of the Lord. Let me use the young people here. For example, you want to get married and you have your list of, the list of characteristics. I want a tall black man or a plumpy brown lady. Must be working, driving. Speaks good English. Has good etiquette. So every time you go out and one of those things are not met, the man is nicely black and tall and strong, but wait until he starts to eat. So you say, because of that, I'm not getting married. God's ways may not be your ways. His methods may not be your methods. The one that is prepared for you may not be in line with the characteristics that you have placed. What you need to do is, God, I'm trusting you. And you pray. And even if he eats like whatever, and God says, this is the man, you say, amen. Slowly by slowly, you can tell him, people don't eat this fast. Where are you rushing to? I want you to enjoy this food. And nicely, slowly, the man changes to meet the need that you wanted. But if you reject every method of God, maybe God does not want to increase your finances through your job. He doesn't want to use the promotion. And you are praying for financial blessings, for promotion. And that's the time your job is in, is in a crisis. You're on the list of the people that are going to be retrenched. And they're saying, God, how can this happen? Maybe his way was not for you to be there. He wants you kicked out so that you can get that into that business so that he can lift you up. But you are saying, no, that cannot work. And you are fighting your ways. At the place of work, you are fighting everybody. You are threatening them with curses from the scripture. Don't touch, the child of God. You boss, if you put me on that list, you are the one who's going to be fired. And then you end up fired and they are looking at you and saying, so, utadu, we are still here and you are just gone. But God may be saying, my son, I never wanted to bless you financially at KPA. I never wanted to bless you financially in Mabati Rawlings. I wanted you to get out and do something. Praise the name of the Lord. And now you cry, and then God blesses you. Praise the name of the Lord. The methods of God may not be your own method. There are people who just want, you spiritualize everything, and it's just prayer and breakthrough here, breakthrough there. And the breakdowns are coming instead of breakthroughs. God's way of lifting you up may be through breakdowns, not breakthroughs. Praise the name of the Lord. You have heard the story of this man who, got stranded. I don't know whether he was, I can't get the story properly, but the man got stranded, gone into the sea and gone way off and got stranded. Began to pray for God to deliver him and no help was coming. So he decided, I have to survive here. I have to make something. So he made up a makeshift structure for him to survive on top of a tree. So he would go out and fend for himself and then go back there. And, he had given up to fate. It's like God is not hearing. God is not going to answer. So he's trying to make himself comfortable. He's trying to do what we tell you to do. He's making lemonade out of the lemon. And say, God will not answer. And then one day he comes, and instead of God's help, even the makeshift structure that he had, that has now become his home, was on fire. Totally razed. You know, it is in blaze. So the man begins to cry and say, oh God, even the only thing that I expected will, you know, I will survive in. Now even this one, the fire. God, where are you? Why do you allow these kind of things to happen? So he cried, praying and crying until he fell asleep, only to be woken up by a ship that had come now to rescue him. And they said, he asked, how did you know I was here? And they said, we saw your fire signal and we came to rescue you, because you can lit a fire that can send a signal that you are in trouble. He never lit the fire. He was crying against the fire. So you can also have delays because you don't like the method that God is using. Number 9, delay can be caused by God's desire to bring us to repentance. God wants you to turn around from your wicked ways, turn around from your fears and doubts, turn around from living this life and see what I will do. Don't be like the prodigal son when he began to look for his friends and they were nowhere. He must have prayed and said, God, I pray one of those friends that I really took care of, please just talk to them. Let them rescue me. Let them help me. And the friends never came. The solution was delayed. It was not coming. Lord, bless me with a job that I can be able to take care of myself. Lord, I pray. I'm ready to work now. No job was coming through. The only thing he could do was take care of pigs. And even at this place of taking care of pigs, he was not being taken care of properly. He can't even have proper food. God had not forgotten him. God had not written him off. God was not saying, I don't care what you go through. God was saying, turn around. And the Bible says, that is Luke 15, when the man came to his senses, then he said, I have sinned against you and against my father. And when he went back home, asking to be made a slave like the ones that his father had, he was given a new robe and he was given a ring in his finger, and a fatted calf was slaughtered on his behalf. Maybe God is waiting for you to turn around, so that he can bless you, so that he can restore you, so that he can release the things into your life. You are busy praying, God, do this, do that, do that. God is saying, I want to do more. I want to bless you with more. I want to take you farther. I want to do great things. But what I'm waiting is for you to turn around. Repent. Hallelujah. Are there delays in your life? If you look back at the expectation that you had, from the last time I checked, I have several of them that have not been met, that I wrote down. And maybe you too have some expectations this year that have not happened. Don't spiritualize it. Don't blame God. Don't blame people around you. And don't just decide, I'm going to make lemonade out of this lemon. Maybe God just wants you to do something. believe him, trust him, honor him, follow his commands, accept his method, repent, and God will do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you can ever think or imagine. Shall we stand on our feet? If you're here, and there are expectations in 2016 that you trusted God to do for you, and some of them have not happened, I wanted to just lift up your hand wherever you are. I want to pray with you. If all your expectations for 2016 have happened, put your hand down. But if you know there are things you trusted God for, there are things you expected, and they have not, some of them have not materialized, and you are still believing God to do something, do a miracle, just lift up your hand wherever you are. Now, the next thing I want you to do, for those whose hands are up, I want you to check your life and ask yourself, could it be as a result of something that I need to do? Am I walking in disobedience? Have I rejected God's method? Am I living in sin? I need to repent. Am I trying to manipulate God? Was it all about pleasure for myself? Or was God to be glorified? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this morning we stand in awe of you. We thank you because you are God. Besides you, there is no other. You are the Almighty God, the creator of the entire universe. Nothing is too hard for you. All things are possible. And right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that you will help me. Help me, O God, to do what I need to do so that I can be able to receive answers and solutions to whatever it is that I'm trusting you for. I place my expectations before you. And Lord, I pray for these dear ones, Father. Touch them, minister to them in a very special way. Whatever they need to do, O God, once it is done, Lord, the Bible says in Psalm 81 that we will be surprised how quickly you will deliver, how quickly you will provide, how quickly you will make a way, how quickly you will open those doors. So let it be in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's give the Lord a good hand this morning.